What happened, man? It's your boy Woop, man. I just jumped off the porch with my dirty glove bastard, man. You already know.
Hold up, Woopy, that no cap. You talking way too many facts. Word to the man, I'm gonna blow like the fan.
All right, so we got the one and only Woop jumping off the porch with us today, man.
You already know, man. I'm straight off the porch, West Orlando. You are in the building.
Yes, sir, man.
To be exact.
Yeah, man. Nah, I appreciate you coming by. I know we've been supporting you for a long time, man. We even tried setting this up when you first came home, too. Just couldn't make it happen, but
we here now. Shit, you already know.
Yeah.
Let's do it. I fuck with dirty girl off the porch.
For sure, man. Yeah, it's all about that perfect timing, man. So, speaking of perfect timing, man, you got this new project going crazy, man.
Hey, man, yeah. That's why we here, you know what I'm saying, I'm promoting it. Dirty Face.
Yes, sir.
You already know we in the building, Dirty Face Woop. For all my day ones, originals, supporters, we still here doing it. You already know.
Yeah.
You
know what I'm saying? So, like, what was your inspiration going into this project? Did you feel like, I know you've been reading the comments, man. They saying the old Woop is back. So did you feel like you had to deliver that to them?
Yeah, or what was, man. Yeah. Hey, I swear to God, I was reading the comments. I'm like, damn, man. I'm like, they think I lost it, bro. You feel me? I'm like, man, I got to show this. I can do this shit with my eye closed, you feel me? So I had to go in there. I had dirty face woman like, man, look, man. I went and listened to my old self, you feel me? I'm like, man, this is what it is. I want this sound, you feel me? And that's what I went in there like that. That's how I went in the project.
Okay.
Less.
How many songs would you say you recorded for this project? Did you have a lot to choose from, or?
I probably recorded like 40 songs.
Oh, shit.
I be recording fast. So I might knock out like 3-4 songs in one night, you feel me?
Okay.
So I just go back and pick it.
So you don't be writing, you just be freestyling, punching in there?
Yeah, I punch in.
Okay.
Yeah. I've been doing that too.
Yeah.
For a while.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And they're saying you brought the old flow back, man. I feel like your flow hasn't really changed at all though.
Yeah, man, I don't know. It's just like, you know, people be trending, but so like if one person said who they figure like might know something, you feel me? And then they just might, okay, that's what it is. Or it might be true, you feel me? Sometimes you gotta take your wins and your losses, like, you know what I'm saying, like a man.
Nah, definitely.
So if that's what it is, if that's what it took, then that's what it is, you feel me?
Nah, definitely, man. So when you finally put this project together, you was completely done with it. What you think, man? Did you notice it was gonna get such a good reaction? Or was it just like, all right, let's see what they say, man?
Well, yeah, I was more like, man, let me see what the city talking about. Let me see what they talking about. You feel me? Because I ain't dropped like that. I was like, hey, let me see what they talking about. I want to see what these people, let me see what they, see what they, see how they feeling. See you love me, hate me, what? You feel me?
Yeah.
Get to them.
How did this digital scale with you and Bobby Fishscale come about, man?
Shit, man, I hadn't recorded the song. So then, one day, like, Fishscale, he a real too. Shout out Fishscale,
man. Shout out to Bobby, man.
He hit me one day, he like, man, like, bro, out of respect, you know what I'm saying, nigga, we used to come up to you, and we did real shit to you, you feel me? So, and I already was feeling what he got going on, his, like, you know what I'm saying, the way he attacking the game, I liked it. So I was like, man, I got to get you on one, bro, you feel me? And then he knocked it out for me, you know what I'm saying? No hesitation, you feel me?
Yeah.
I think we sent him the record. He came to Orlando and did some. I forgot exactly how it went, but yeah.
Yeah, the shit turned out really dope, man.
Yeah.
So what does that mean for you? For, you know, Bobby, he kind of like leading, you know, this new Florida wave that's coming out. How does it feel for someone like that to reach out to you and tell you that, like, hey, man, we grew up on you, or
you
maybe not
saying?
Grew up on you, but you know, came up listening to your shit. And actually want to work, because, you know, a lot of rappers like to hold their nuts and be like.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's why I shouted him out, you feel me? Because that's rare, you feel me? Especially when you don't work to get where you at and shit, and you just like, man. But he owed me to keep it real. He just did it, you feel me? You know what I'm saying? Nah, you know what I'm saying? I can't look at him no other way, you feel me?
Yeah.
So it's like, that, man, that was... That's fire, like, to me, you feel me? Like, to know I left an impact on people who doing their thing.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? And he wasn't shy to let a nigga know, you feel me? We ain't shy, you feel me? I respect that.
Yeah, no, that's real. And what about Soulja Kid, man? How'd you guys link up?
I linked up. Our managers put me and Soulja Kid link up. And we linked up, we just went to rocking. So then we just, you know what I'm saying? We linked. Like, he'll come to town, he'll hit me with our push up on him, you feel me? Whatever he got going on. Bro, cool one though, you know what I'm saying? I'll be fucking with him.
Yeah.
I respect, bro. I fuck with him. I had to get him on the tape. You know, he be snapping too, so.
Oh, yeah.
You know what
I'm
saying?
He be going in, man. Yeah. And I'm really fucking with the one with Mook Boy, man. So, you know, I don't know if you guys had worked before, man, or it's been a minute since y'all did, man.
Nah, we never worked.
Which is crazy, man.
We never worked, bro. That was our first time ever. First time ever doing a song ever. You know what I'm saying? We just had a versus that we had did.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that. Who won, man?
I won. Nah, it was, you know what I'm saying? We did our thing, you feel me? They say he won. They say he got me, you feel me? He did his thing. I respect it, you feel me?
Yeah.
We came up to them and shit, like, for real. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, for them to get us in one building on the same,
that was huge, man.
We won, you feel me? We did it for the culture, you feel me?
Yeah.
We can put that shit aside, y'all can put that shit aside, you feel me? And I was on some shit like that.
Yeah, what did that mean for the city to see both of y'all on stage like that, to be able to come together and do that for the city, man?
We packed that shit out.
Oh, I'm sure, man.
We packed that
shit out.
You
almost had me driving down there for that shit.
Man, we packed that shit out. That shit was nice, man. That shit was, you feel me? They came out, the show, the energy, what was really crazy, though. You feel me? And everything was A1, you feel me? Everybody had a good time, did their shit.
Yeah, absolutely.
Went on about their business.
So what's the next video? You got something planned? You got something already tucked and ready, or?
Man, I'm finna shoot about 4 or 5 videos off my album. Dirty Face Woop album, y'all make sure y'all get that. You know what I'm saying? I'm finna shoot about 4 or 5 out there. I'm including the one with Mook Boy.
Okay.
For sure, you feel me? I got a digital scale out with Bobby Fishscale already. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and the one with Soulja Kid, that's that.
So yeah, I'm probably shoot about 4 off my tape. And then go from there.
Yeah, and I saw you mentioned that this is your album, right? Like, this is your first album.
This is my first one,
So what's the difference between this project, making it an album, and all your other ones, which I guess are considered mixtapes, even though they kind of sound like albums, man?
Yeah. and you know what's crazy? That was a management call, to make it an album. No, I'm with it. I never dropped one before. Fuck it. Give them an album, Woop, you feel me?
Yeah. I dig that. All right, man. So let's talk about this Who Wants Smoke remix, man. This shit.
You heard that?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
I think everyone's heard it at this point. You got social media buzzing with this one. So, and you label it as, you know, Hotboii and Rico Cartel diss, man. So why? Why did you decide to go at it?
I didn't label it as that, though. You feel me? Yeah.
Whoever uploaded it labeled it as that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
It's on your channel.
Yeah, it's on my channel. I'm responsible for that. So, yeah, that's what it is, exactly. Feel me? But what you ask me again?
Why is it labeled that, I should say, then?
It's labeled that because that's what it is, really. Like, they got out of line, you feel me? Like, it go back. Like, it's a long story. Like, you feel me? It's like, it's more to it, deeper than what they think. You feel me? Than what they is. So it's like, we had a little situation, little words exchange and shit. Then they previewed a song that I thought, you know what I'm saying? Like a diss song towards me. So then they hit me like, man, I usually don't never do no real, like no diss song like that. You feel me? Like, but it's like, man, fuck that. And I felt like everybody got they, you know what I'm saying? They chest out on me. I'm like, okay, man, let me knock out a nigga chest real quick. You feel me? Let me humble her. I'm the humbler. You feel me? That's what it is. I had to humble something. You feel me?
Why you think they went at you then?
I know why they went at me. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? First of all, they got their own situation, you know what I'm saying? And one of the people they get to is some candy, you feel me? So it's like a...
So they're just like indirectly involved in you.
Like, yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? At one point they wouldn't sign to me and shit, you feel me?
Oh, really?
Yeah, when I first came home from prison, you feel me? And they met with my mom, you feel me? Sat on the floor, you feel me? It was, you know what I'm saying? It was like that. But then it just, hate just went to coming out of nowhere, a little fake shit, you feel me? Speak on me, close friends, that type of shit, you feel me?
We going, hopefully this just stays on wax, man. Because like you said, it's not really between y'all and them, it's just indirect, so, yeah. Say no more.
You feel me?
But let's talk about the Orlando music scene, man. And I specifically want to ask you, like, what do you feel like your role was here in the Orlando music scene, man?
Man, you know what I'm saying? I kicked the door down, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Not to say that, but you know what I'm saying? What they hear is like mini me's, you feel me? You know what I'm saying? They all harmonizing or rapping, all this shit, you feel me? Like freestyling, blueprinting, you know what I'm saying? The way they kicking it to them. But it's like, don't nobody, oh man, I got that done. But if you keep it real, niggas will let you know, like, damn, bro, we, you know what I'm saying? People sound like this, but we went more after this, you feel me? That's the, and it's, cause Orlando had a whole different sound. It was like, around this time, it's like when Orlando had like the older dudes, Armstrong and Mook Boys and shit. They was like the Mohawks, so you had like more like the grimy little finesse Florida talk going on. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
And Woop come with the
know
what
I'm saying? Flow,
the choppy,
man.
The flow, the ad libs right behind it, the harmony. You know what I'm saying? Then it's like, that's what's going on now, you feel me? But it's like, and it's from all around the world. Like, I done went, worked with a whole bunch of artists who done bit my shit, and like, I skyrocket off of it, you feel me?
Absolutely.
And that's part of my motivation, you feel me? So it's like, damn. What, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna come to light, you feel me? For sure.
But it's like you really took it national.
Nationally, that's what I mean, like, kicked the door, like, as far as, like, letting people know, like, this shit down here, like, ain't Disney. You feel me? A lot of people who won national, they ain't know about what Orlando really was.
Yeah, especially the West Side, either.
They don't know nothing about that West Orlando. They don't really know. You know what I'm saying? All they know is, they don't even know Disney is in Kissimmee. Mm-hmm. They don't know.
It's not even in Orlando.
They don't know that. You feel me? So it's like, that's the type of shit you gotta deal with.
Yeah. So do you feel like you get your proper props? People recognize you for kicking down them doors, or did they forget?
Yeah, people show me love in real life. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, anybody who just like, straight up or a man or neutral about some situation, you feel me? They fuck with me online and type shit. But you know what I'm saying? People be faking like we got issues. You know what I'm saying? Cause they got it. You know what I'm saying? Little boy shit.
Yeah.
That's the type of shit going on, you feel me?
Yeah, and fast forward into today, man, there's so many buzzing artists come out, but why do you think we hear about so much beef between the artists though, man?
Cause that's what they want to hear that so they could crash, and they, you know what I'm saying? People want to ride to see how long you last crash with your move on. You know what I'm saying? That's what they want. That's what's going on nowadays, you feel me? Ain't even really about the music no more, it's about what type of, What he got? Who he into it with? You feel me? Grown ass men who never been into it. That's what they want. You feel me? They want that at you. They ain't never been into nothing though. You feel me? That's what they want.
Now that's wild right there. And it seems like, you know, you don't really do those type of gimmicks, man. Like, this is, like I said, this is probably the first time we ever heard you, like, get into it with the other rappers, man.
Yeah, for real.
Was that, like, your plan when you came into the game? Like, man, I'm blow up off the music and that's it, man. It ain't about this other shit.
Yeah, it wasn't never really about that with me, you feel me? It's like, I indirect might say some shit. I don't never, like, pinpoint some shit, you feel me? I don't really be, you feel me? Cause I move around, so it ain't like nigga know what it is with me. Cause I go direct to you. I just say something to you on some like off the music type shit. You feel me? So I ain't never really get this, but it's like these niggas so internet-y. I gotta, you feel me? okay, this what they think you lit at? Okay, I'm going at you here then. Show them that this what it is, for real. You feel me? That's what it is.
Nah, I feel that, man. All right, so, you know, this breakthrough song, Pussy, man, like, first of all, what was you going through that day that you recorded that shit, man? Were you mad at someone? Or?
You can say pussy nigga, man.
I ain't gonna say it.
No. There's a lot going on, actually. But it's like, me and my homeboy, we was finna go to the studio, and there was a situation going on around us that, you know, I was with every day was, you know what I'm saying? They had some shit going on, you feel me? And it's like, and we had some shit going on, but it's like, they shit was more like, I guess more known, you feel me? Hmm. And one of my homeboys, who I shouted out and shit, who I knew from the mud, you know what I'm saying? He passed away in that shit, you feel me?
Oh, shit.
So it was just like, I shot him out, and it's like, that song inspired that, you feel me? And that's what happened.
So I take it, you did not expect that to be the song to break you through, or when you got done, you was like, hold on, I might be sitting on something here.
I didn't expect it to be the song, but when it got out, how fast it went to moving.
Yeah, it did take off fast.
That's when I was like, wait, hold on, what the fuck going on? You feel me? I'm with my dog, we chilling on the block or whatever we doing every day. You know what I'm saying? Hanging, Plies calling up. Oh shit! How you got my number, bro? You feel me? That type of vibe. You feel me? That's how fast it took off. So I was like, damn.
And what type of reaction do you get when you perform it today, man? Is it still as turned up? People fighting in the club, all that man, shit.
It ain't as the fighting and shit ain't bad as it used to be, but they still turn up. They still turn up to that shit. 10 years later, bro, like it just came out, like, get booked for this shit, you feel me? Like,
oh, yeah.
We still going, like, up off this shit. And go away, too, they go up to go away, you feel me? So it's like, damn, I left something that stick with the people, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Like, not to say, but it's like, I can't really be getting to it with niggas who ain't never, like, even did nothing that stuck with the people yet, you feel me? So it'd be my fault. I'd be going backwards, playing with these little babies and shit. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? I gotta whoop my own ass for that. You feel me? I played.
Yeah. So how did the remix come about, man? You got Plies, Gotti, Kevin Gates, and I'm sure 100 other rappers either remixing the song or trying to get on the remix.
I got so many free verses for that. I'll put new. I say, God damn, I said, so this how the rap work? You know what I'm saying? I ain't no shit. You
everyone
know
wants to get on
you
the hit record.
You hear the nigga, they like, oh yeah, this much for a verse. You feel me? A lot of artists, like, who I hit up back then, like, who used to try to charge me, came around and pushed a nigga around, like, getting verses and shit, you feel me? So it's like, but nah, not just, like, the big artists, the remix and shit, bro. Like, them niggas was throwing, like, blessings off of, they fuck with that song so tough. It's like, man. Well, I gotta tap in with you on this song, you feel me? And that's what they was like fucking with that song, you feel me? So it's like, and they could feel the song personally, because I'm pretty sure everybody could feel this situation in every city, some type of way, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
So that's how that came about.
No, absolutely, yeah. And then you followed up, man, with Go Away. And this shit, I'm sure you still get a good reaction when you perform this one, man. This was a hit too.
Man.
But on a completely different vibe, too.
I'm telling you. Still turn right now, like, Go Away. Like, if you remember back then, I put Go Away, like, towards the end of the tape. I didn't even know. It was like a throw-on, you feel me? I did a song one day. I remember me and P.I. Man, I did a song in, like, 20 minutes. Because my session was almost over. And we couldn't find no beat, so I did that. You feel me?
That's why.
That's how Go Away. None of us picked Go Away, like,
Did the people pick it then? How did that end up being the single then?
We promoted other songs. Go Away was like towards the end. It went to growing legs. It hit like 1 million or 2 million something by itself. And that's when we was like, hey, hold on. We gotta shoot video, you feel me? That's how that happened.
Okay. And I saw you just posted on IG that you had Bobby Shmurda on the remix. Well, you never put it out because he went to jail?
No, it did. I had put the Bobby Shmurda. I put the Bobby Shmurda remix with the Migos.
I
had dropped it on YouTube.
Yeah.
But I made the final one, and I had dropped one with Bobby Shmurda, and I dropped the final one with the Migos.
Okay. Yeah, that's what it was. So have you been able to reach out to Bobby? Have y'all talked, man? Because, like you said in your post, man, I could still shoot a video for this, and this shit will go up, man.
Yeah, but I ain't, you know what I'm saying, bro doing his thing. He just came home. He got you know what I'm saying? I had DM'd him or whatever, but I guess he ain't see it yet or whatever. You know how that go. You feel me? Yeah, what it is. You might see it one day.
Okay. So how'd you end up getting the Migos on it? Did they reach out to jump on that, or?
Yeah, they were fucking me tough then. I used to be pulling up on them, like, in Atlanta. You feel me? I used to meet with them and pee and stuff.
I know you and Longway had a solid relationship.
Yeah, I used to always pull up on Longway. That's my boy. Every time I hit him up, that's my boy. But I used to, matter of fact, me and Migos, they booked us together at Tallahassee. Mm. And that's how we met each other, at a FAMU classic.
Okay, yeah.
So they booked us together, whatever. Yeah. And that's how that went.
Yeah, and you and Longway, man, y'all got some classics too, man. Did y'all ever talk about doing like a tape together? I know that was before like there was a wave of, you know, rappers collabing and actually putting out a full tape, man. But yeah, I think y'all had three or four of those.
We used to be talking about the shit then, you know what I'm saying? You know, dog be so motherfucking busy then I might go to jail and shit, you know, different little shit like that. But you know what I'm saying? A couple times, dude reached out to him like, bro, I need you on this right here. He'll do it for me, like, off the love, you feel me?
Yeah.
So it was like, I would fuck with it.
Nah, absolutely. Every song you guys dropped, that shit, I would fuck with that shit. That shit was hard, man. And what about Rock Out Woop, man? There's like a whole nother vibe from you, man.
Yeah, man. My engineer, man, they're like, man, we need you to do some. You got the hoods, you got to do some type of commercial. You feel me? I say, man, what, man? They made a beat one day, I come, they like, bro, just jump on this beat. That's how I made the Rock Out Woop. I just went and I was like, okay, let me try some. I'm thinking commercial, you feel me?
Yeah.
Like, that's where they came. That's what they got.
Nah, that shit was a hit, man. Woop Nation, Woop Lingo, same year too, man.
Woop Nation, Woop Lingo, Dirty Face, Woop. Tell him.
Yeah, so, man, like, talk about just how big your buzz was back then in, like, 2014, man. This shit was, it seemed like,
man,
it was colossal,
that shit,
man.
What, man, that shit had me meeting everybody I wanted to meet off a song, you feel me? Like, sport me in this rap shit, for real. Like, I ain't never had to do the grinding part. I was like, hey, man, I rap. Hey, man, we trying to book you for a show. You feel me? It was like that, so it's kind of like, I ain't do the grind rap part. You feel me? I ain't know nothing about, like, oh, you got to go here and do this, then go here and do this. Just to, you feel me?
Yeah.
So it's like, now I'm understanding, but that's how that went.
Then you had to go sit down, unfortunately, man. So, Where were you at mentally, knowing you got these hot-ass songs, you got these fire-ass tapes out, and now you got to go sit down for 30 months? So.
But you know what's crazy? Mentally, I was already ready, because you know what? They had gave me so long on papers, I knew I was going to violate. You feel me?
How long were you on papers for?
I didn't think they gave me something crazy, like 10 years or some
God
shit.
God damn.
I think I did like 7, some shit. I made it. I violated like a lot of time, though. They spared me. They was kind of sparing me, you feel me? But they hit my ass on the last one. Basically, all the time I did on paper, they was like, fuck that. We finna send you to prison. I went to prison off of something I did way back then, you feel me?
Yeah.
Everybody was like, bro, you had to miss him, you feel me? It was an attempted murder charge. They just dropped it to that, you feel me?
So really?
Like, yeah, so it's like, it was already handled, so it's like, man, that shit was crazy. It's like, people be seeing me, oh, bro, where you got the missile from? Because you know what I'm saying? I went to jail, they talking about
throwing you got a real, like, rocket launcher.
Yeah, rocket launcher, you feel me? That's what it said, throwing some shit like that, something crazy. Nah, ain't no army, man.
Yeah. So how would you describe your experience in there? Like, people, I'm sure people are familiar with you and your music, man, even though you had to cut the dreads off and everything.
Man,
you,
that shit spread so fast, and they waiting on me. It's like, boy, whoop, come here. Boy. And they got their raps ready.
Really?
Everything they got, what you need, you know what I'm saying? They fucking with me so tough, like, you feel me? And then niggas actually meet me and then sit around me for a month. They like, damn, bro, solid, he like one of us, you feel me? Cause I wasn't in no, like, protective camp. I was in
General Pop.
Yeah, the whole, yeah, I was in prison. Not fed, I was in state prison, you feel me?
So when you came home, did you feel like you were starting all over again? Was I know there was a lot of excitement for your release, though, but did you feel like...
Man, I wasn't ready for none of that shit. I'm looking for everything weird. I mean, I'm like, man, what the fuck? Bro, because I used to be tripping, like, I used to be sitting there, and it seemed like, you know how you looking at the window? And then I look at that shit, I see, like, blue and red light. So then I got to check the blinds. Be tripping, I'm like, man, what the fuck going on? And just being in there, like, used to hearing doors, boom. And then not hearing that shit or being able to just, man, I'm finna go get me some drink. In the middle of the night and type of shit. I miss that type of shit, you feel me? Cause in there, you know, everything, time at certain time, you train your body in that, but you accustom yourself to what's going on. So, you know what I'm saying? That become regular to you, you feel me? When then you get out, you be fucked up. You gonna be fucked, I don't care who you gonna be. You ain't gonna know it, but you gonna, you know what I'm saying? People around you gonna be like, yeah, he changed, you feel me? Mm. That's how that type of shit went.
So like, how long did it take for you to, you know, get adjusted being free and be like, all right, man, I'm Woop, man.
Man, that shit took me about a year and a half.
Oh shit, really?
Hell yeah, bro. Cause I ain't gonna lie, them people try to do it to me. They had me in a box for like 5 months, bro, by myself and that shit. No phone calls, 2 hours a week, you feel me? They try to, going through your mail, sometimes not sending your mail, like, you feel me?
That's it.
They were with the bullshit in there, you feel me?
Did that affect your music, you feel like? Because you weren't in the right state of mind when you were recording?
Yeah, that's what they said. They said it affected me, you know what I'm saying? I told you, I don't know, you feel me? To me, I'm like, when they say it, I'm like, man, I can do this though, you feel me? But I'm thinking like, damn, elevation type shit, you feel me? They, man, we want that, you feel me? Fuck it, you know what I'm saying? That's how that went.
Yeah. Were you writing or rapping while you were locked up or not really?
I was, bro, killing time, bro. I ain't use none of that shit, bro. You feel me? I'm in there rapping with no beats and shit. Kicking the lock, making the beat, you feel me?
So, Peek Out though, man. That was the first one you dropped when you came home?
Yeah, yeah.
Was that something you had recorded as soon as you came home, or was that something you had stashed away already?
Nah, I recorded when I came home.
Okay. That shit was hard though, man.
Yeah, that's why I understand. That's why I was like, damn. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? The mixing went all that fire. The mixing went all that good on that tape, but it's like,
yeah.
It is what it was.
What about Backstreet Shawty, man? I feel like this should have been a nationwide hit, man. That song was so fucking dope.
I don't know what it be, man. It's like, one day that shit, you know what I'm saying? Somebody gonna catch on and get that real push that it deserve, you feel me? But it's like, that shit, I don't know what it be, but like, nigga can feel that song too. Like, a lot of people came up with, it might be in a hood, it might be a front street, they might be the back street, you feel me? Niggas felt that song even if, you feel me? Or they can switch the word to front street shot or whatever, you feel me? However they kick it.
Nah, that shit was just so catchy, man. Like, you couldn't help but sing along to that hook to it, man.
I'm telling you.
Yo.
I fuck with that. I'm glad you know about that, bro.
Oh, for sure, man. You know, we was covering all that shit as soon as it dropped, man. We was posting all this shit back in the day.
Yeah, you been fucking with me, though. I ain't gonna cap.
Yeah.
You been fucking with me.
So what's your thoughts on like the rap game, music industry, everything that's going on now and how it compared to when you were first coming up, man? Because it definitely seems more social media driven these
days. Yeah, that's
man.
All it is now, like the right picture, the right, whatever, the right argument. You feel me? That's what it is now, like when we was around, like they didn't have all that shit, bro. Like they knew who we was because they were hearing about us like, damn, bro. Jit them wild as hell. What they were, we were doing this shit. You feel me? Nah, niggas don't even gotta be doing. They can know the person who doing it. And you know what I'm saying? They don't even. Nah, they ain't doing it. You feel me? Not with it. Oh, it, you feel me?
Should be weird, man.
Weird as hell. It's like they need to just go to believing that they're doing it too. You feel me? That's what's crazy. And it's like, yeah, boom. You know what I'm saying? Humble your ass, you feel me?
Yeah.
Nah, man, hey, snap back, man. This who you is, man. Chill out.
For sure, man.
What you do.
You're fully independent right now?
Yes, sir. All the way.
Yeah. So, do you look to sign with a major? Do you look for another partnership like you had in the past, or?
Yeah, we get the right push, you feel me? But it's like, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? If that shit made sense and we want to do it, let's do it. Cause I got the music to do it, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Put the house on me.
Nah, definitely, bro. All right, so what's some of your plans for 2022? What you got planned, man?
Dirty Face Woop, man, you know. We still doing shows and shit, you know what I'm saying? Trying to make the people feel me, reconnecting with the people. That's what I'm doing 2022, you feel me? Keep press the gas on them though, for sure.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? See what it do.
Plan to do a deluxe, or are you on to the next project?
I might do a deluxe around my birthday or some shit. I might fuck with them.
When's your birthday?
December 6th.
Okay. So I might get something real soon then.
I might drop a deluxe, man. I might do that. 5 songs or some shit that ain't even on the project.
Yeah.
Dirty Face Woop Deluxe.
Yeah.
Too dirty.
That's hard right there. That's hard. All right, Woop, you got any last words for your fans you'd like to give? Any shout outs, man?
Yes, man. Shout out Day One supporters. You already know, follow me at therealwoopwoop.com. At therealwoopwoop on Instagram. You already know, man. Shout out Dirty Love. Shout out Woop. Shout out my whole squad who fucked with me, who locked in with me. Shout out myself. Y'all know, shout out Yellow House.
Nah, fuck. I won't be fucking with dog, cause dog be fucking with rats. And rats be fucking with snakes. And snakes get hit with the axe.